T minus 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery with the Hubble Space Telescope, our window on the universe.
The Hubble telescope's become so iconic because it's allowed us to get images of things that we couldn't see before.
Be extra careful at not touching any of this MLI in any of these bays up here, because it's just, I think there's good potential for pieces to come off.
By studying these materials, we are able to understand why this material is degrading in space. Hubble was launched in 1990, and there were a couple different problems that occurred after it was first deployed. NASA planned servicing missions to fix problems, but also for upgrading scientific equipment. I was very fortunate to be involved in each of the five different servicing missions. For the first servicing mission that had this thermal-induced jitter problem, the solar arrays that were launched with Hubble had these metal poles, and as Hubble orbited around the Earth, these poles would get hot and cold in the sunlight and the shadow of the Earth, and so they'd expand and contract, and that caused a vibration. When Hubble was vibrating because of that, it would not be able to point on distant stars and galaxies, and so that was a problem. One of the things that NASA planned was to work with the European Space Agency, who built the solar arrays, to design new arrays that would have thermal insulation barriers on these metal poles. One of the roles that I had was to help the team who did space environmental testing of these thermal shield candidate materials. And my primary role was to characterize the materials after they had been exposed to these different simulated space environments.
I was selected for the Glenn Hubble team because I'm a subject matter expert in atomic oxygen, and that's one of the environments that was around the Hubble Space Telescope. One of the things I did was look at how atomic oxygen affects the material, and found that their one material that they wanted to use would be fine for the duration of the Hubble telescope.
These samples are the actual test samples, and some of them have a protective coating. Like this one has like an iridescent kind of look to it. And I found after they were exposed to simulated space environment of atomic oxygen and UV radiation at Glenn, those sparkles ended up being the coating coming off of the material. The material is aluminized Teflon. That was obviously going to be a big problem if that happened up in space on the Hubble telescope. So we concluded that the best design for Hubble was to use this aluminized Teflon, but without the protective coating. When the new arrays were launched, the telescope worked and there was no thermal jitter.
I was sitting at my desk one day and just got a random phone call. The voice on the other end said, "This is Mission Control." And I'm thinking, okay, this is a joke, right? But no, it was really Mission Control. And they had just replaced one of the gyroscopes and they couldn't get the door to shut.
It's not closing. The doors aren't closing right.
So one of the questions the astronauts had was, well, I don't have any way of getting this door to stay shut, but I've got some tie wraps on me. Can I use these in the environment? I quickly looked up some information about atomic oxygen and the tie wrap material and confirmed that they could use the tie wrap to hold the door shut. So that was kind of a unique experience, and I haven't been called for by Mission Control since.
I think we got the door closed.
Yes, and the pump is engaged. All right.
Whew. So part of my work for Hubble was analyzing insulation materials brought back from Hubble. I actually have a sample of a section of a thermal shield. This is a pristine one, which means it was never exposed in space. And I also have a section of the actual solar array thermal shield that was up in space for 8.25 years. So one side of the thermal shield always pointed towards the sun, and that surface got very embrittled.
There's that tail they were touching.
Greg, while we're getting some pictures, just a reminder, the first thing we're going to do is cut off a curled edge from the torn area, about a 4x4 or bigger, and put it in the trash bag.
The second servicing mission, when the astronauts went up and captured it, they found that there were large cracks in the outer layer of multi-layer insulation blankets. And this was a big surprise because that material is normally very stretchy. So Goddard Space Flight Center convened a failure review board, and I was invited to be a part of this failure review board to understand why the insulation covering the telescope was becoming embrittled in the space environment.
On later servicing missions, there was some of the material that was starting to fall apart, and they were looking at ways to cover it or replace it so that the telescope could function longer.
This is an example of the material that was retrieved from Bay 8. This material should look like this little corner down here. This is a piece of pristine aluminized Teflon. Up in space, the aluminum is coming off of the material and it's becoming very brittle and cracked. Just as an example, if I shift this a little bit, this is a huge crack, and there's an impact site here, and there are several small impact sites in the material. This is a very common thermal control material that is used by many different spacecraft designers, and so the knowledge we gained from Hubble is impacting other space missions in addition.
This is a really tremendous adventure that we've been on, a very challenging mission. Hubble isn't just a satellite. It's about humanity's quest for knowledge.
To be part of the Hubble Space Telescope servicing missions was really exciting. I consider it like one once-in-a-lifetime kind of experience, but I think one of the great benefits of working here at NASA is that you have the opportunity for many once-in-a-lifetime experiences.
I've worked on a lot of very interesting flight experiments and flight missions, but certainly Hubble has been a real career highlight for me. The scientific discoveries about the universe have been very eye-opening, and I think it's been a really wonderful source of inspiration.
We were able to see how many more galaxies there are out there and how many more solar systems, and it just boggles the mind how many new things that we can discover with it.